so good to see y'all here this evening. It's been a wonderful day up here on Chocolate Street. It started several years ago, and I want to welcome y'all to this song service of worship, and I'll lift our voices to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Father, we're going to start with a number that talks about Holy Spirit. Now, in this place.
Yes. Out of Hope it ain't that challenging.
It's favorite hymn to sing tonight, and I've asked a few people in the choir to share what their favorite hymn is, and mine is their favorite hymn. How loud?
When the morning comes, was my mother's favorite, one of my mother's favorite songs. And I hope we're gonna sing it tonight, when the morning comes. So I want you to listen to the words, they're real good. When I was a little girl, we had an old pop organ at home, and when she was feeling low, she would go in and pump that old organ and sing alto. She had a beautiful alto voice. And you know, I can almost hear her now singing that beautiful alto voice, when the morning comes.
Thank you, Mrs. Dallas. So take your hymnal that's in front of you, turn to 615. We'll sing the first and the last verse of When the Morning Comes. Let's stand and sing. Amen, and you may be seated. Jane is coming to sing for us this evening.
It's pretty, Baptist Church will always have a special place in my heart. We got a lot of families, eyes of this church, parents, brothers, and fathers and charter members. They were two of the group of people that met together years and years ago, and they had the two things they did for prayer and being, their vision was to have a church on the highest growth of our country. And God heard their prayers, and that's what we got today. Sharon was baptized in the church. I was baptized in the got married in his dirt. I just love to leave his mom over there in his dirt. When I first started coming here for the first time, I was just a young teenage boy. And we started coming on Sunday night, but I wasn't coming to hear anything Brother Sample had to say. It was a pretty little teenage girl that was sitting there. I wanted to sit with her so bad. I kind of let me sit with her. 55 years later, we still sit together.
Yeah.
Miss Kate Harrington, your favorite hymn. If you will stand and tell us what it is and why it's your favorite hymn.
I hope you enjoyed tonight. Stop out my knees and grab hold of it. Oh,
asked Ms. Phyllis Watts, I'm pastor's wife, to share what her favorite hymn is.
My favorite hymn is It Is Well. And the reason for that is 10.5 years ago, our daughter was in a terrible automobile accident. She and her baby. And we got a second call saying that the baby made it, but she didn't. And an hour and a half trip to the hospital where she was, even though our world had turned upside down, there was peace in my soul. And when we got close to the hospital, my husband said, God has given me, it is well with my soul. And I said, me too. And that's why it's my favorite. In the midst of the toughest storm I've ever been through, God let me know, it is well with my soul.
And then somebody else is in this congregation tonight, the same song. I got a text this morning from a young lady that I've known for years. And I watched her grow up here in this church and be a part of the youth. I just want to share this text that she texted me this morning. It says, my all-time favorite hymn is, It Is Well With My Soul. That's due to you and my mama. I had always liked the hymn, but one Sunday in church, you read the story behind the hymn, and it took on a different meaning to me. Thank you for sharing that. It made a change in me. Then when mama passed away, that song immediately came to my mind, and I had to have it at her funeral. I knew that no matter how much pain I had, God was to make it okay. It is well with my soul. I still listen to it every day. I start missing mama really bad. I know my soul is well, no matter how bad the pain. It got me through some rough days soon after the passing. It still does. Thank you for sharing that story. I will forever thank God. Thank God for speaking to me that day because He knew I was going to need it. One day, she said, I listened to it this morning, thinking of Mama. She would be so proud of all of you, what y'all are doing this weekend, and would be right there working with you. That was Miss Patsy Kirkland. I worked with her together for probably close to 20, 21, 22 years. And I went, she's been gone 5, 6 years now. And I miss her dearly, but you know, there's a day that's coming that see the
book. And I praise God.
For Jesus. And you know, me and her, one of her daughters told me that it was something about the hills, joint of the hills, we would get mad at one another from time to time, but yet we still love one another, too. I mean, we would forgive, you know, instead of holding a grudge in our hearts and then working with somebody for that many years, it's like a family. And then she would, from time to time, she would say, you're going to miss me when I'm gone. And you know, in fact, the day that she died, she told me that. And I stood in her grave about 2 or 3 weeks after she passed away and just saw her. Because I do miss her. But y'all let us join in and sing all verses to her to eat as well. Thank you, Stacy, for that text this morning.
It's 447.
447. And it may be several other people's favorite hymn in this congregation tonight.
It is my God.
sing it. It talks about the risen Lamb. No more night.
You knew it was coming.
why they say that, you know.
I'm telling you, give me a microphone and look.
Anyway, Ronnie asked me, called my name at choir practice, and he said, Marcus, I want you to tell your favorite hymn. And I said, okay, can I bring the Baldwin hymnal in here? No, you don't know all of them, but I just do not have no special favorite hymn, because they speak so much to me, all of the hymns. And it seems like the older hymns are the ones that, of course, ones I grew up with, and they just speak to my heart, you know. But this one hymn, I'm going to bring this up, and I picked this out because of my baby grandson.
Thank you.
Now, my baby grandson, he's usually, y'all probably don't know him, but he's usually up there in the back up there top when he runs his thing up here. And he's such a little feller. Marcus Simmons. And his mother told me this one time, that when he was tiny, when he was a baby, and you couldn't hardly get him to sleep without singing to him. And one of the favorite songs that he would go to sleep really quick with was the old Rugged Cross. And that has been such a special song in my heart, because y'all really need to remember the cross and what God did on that cross to save us from our sins. Because he bled and died right there. And if it had just been me, he would have done the same thing. He would have bled for my sins, covered over my sins. And y'all, I know that everybody has had said, you don't get much. We've all had sins in our lives, and he has we just ask him for forgiveness, and he forgives us, and he is so precious in my heart, in my life, and I just praise him for what he is. And let's just remember the old Rugged Cross, and I don't know what number it is. 230, hymn number 230.
Yes, 230. It's one of mine too, Marcus. We'll sing the first, third, and last.
Thank you.
Is there anybody here that would like for us to sing your favorite hymn tonight? Yes, sir.
Spirit, wash me with blood.
benediction tonight turns to hymn number 28, To God Be the Glory. Let us stand and we'll sing the first and the last verse of To God Be the Glory. Let us stand.